Mijn naam is Jet Akkerman.
Mijn naam is Joke.
Mijn naam is Mark Kuiken.
Mijn naam is Jet Akkerman.
Mijn naam is
Jet Akkerman.
Mijn naam is Mark Kuiken.
Mijn naam is Joke.
Wood.
Wood.
Why?
Hout. It's in my name, Wood. My last name means wood. So, I guess it's in my blood or something.
My name is Mark Kuiken. I joined Co-Creation because I wanted to start my own project. And not one that was created by school, because I wanted to do my own thing. And that project turned out to be the Beehive Hotel. The Beehive Hotel is a sleeping arrangement made of sleeping capsules. And they're modular, so you can stack them up really high or just use one of them. And you can place them anywhere, and that's the project I started in Co-Creation.
Que pasa?
The idea came up when the organization Culturele Hoofdstad 2018 asked us to brainstorm about the lack of sleeping places for the people coming to Leeuwarden because of this event. And then we came to this photos of other people who made sleeping cabins, which looked like this with the six edges, and we took their idea to create something more.
Mijn naam is Jet Akkerman, ben 25 jaar oud en studeer docent beeldende kunst en vormgeving en ik volg de minor co-creatie.
Go creatie is create together and do it. Not only think about it, but do it. Make it. One idea, okay, it's enough. Make it and learn of it.
This minor, this way of teaching, it's really useful because we bring together a lot of people from different educations, different angles, and they all think about problems in a different way, and they all know solutions in a different way. So when you put all those people together, you get really creative solutions to problems, and that's great. It's the only place I know of that provides a place where that can happen. It's like a supercharged think tank.
Wat ik in de groep heb gecreëerd is het mensennest waar ik in zit. En ik heb berkenwijn gemaakt en ik heb kleren van vilt en haakwerk gemaakt. Oh, en nu alles samen is een hele mooie symbolische verbinding met elkaar heeft dat eigenlijk. Het heeft ook een hele beleving dat je natuurlijke producten kan combineren ook met harde producten zoals staal en dat alles samenkomt en dat alles weer terug in de natuur zoals en oude ambachten. Het zijn ook eigenlijk allemaal oude ambachten die ik heb uitgevonden en door eigenlijk gewoon maar te doen.
I want to inspire young people with nature, but also see at the problems with nature. And how can we restore or how can we help or create awareness? And also bring felt into education, because a lot of people, young people, don't know what felt is. What is felt? wool, water, soap, rubbing, and then magic. You make a piece of felt.
We are connected to each other because we are working all on different projects that are connected to the bee, to create the
awareness.
Awareness, thank you.
Well, I'm a felt artist, but I'm also a teacher. And Silence of the Bee started for me as a felt artist with the felt project, the beehive, the felt beehive. And when I was working on that project, I thought I can connect it with education and also connect students, young people on that project, and also work together with young creative people. And that's why I brought it into education. I brought it into co-creation.
I would describe Silence of the Bees as a group of people that are really dedicated on solving the bee problem, but not in a organization kind of way, but more of a, it's a group of like-minded people that are coming from different angles to try to solve the problem in creative ways. All the projects inside co-creation are linked to Silence of the Bees. It's always a sort of guideline inside the miner to do a project that's connected in some way or another to Silence of the Bees.
And it's also giving students an context. They're not going on every direction. It's not making me happy, but more focus. I need more focus.
Het idee achter het mensennest is het is ook eigenlijk voor het project Silence of the Bees. En ik wil aandacht trekken ook voor de bijen en voor de natuur op zich. En met het mensennest heb ik een nieuwe symbolische verbinding willen creëren tussen de mens en natuur. En die dieren voelen zich ook fijn en veilig in zo'n nest. En dat wou ik ook graag maken voor de mens.
The beehive hotel uses its shape to cause awareness for the bees. It's shaped like a beehive with its shapes of the sleeping capsules and also the colors. And we create awareness for the bees because of the story.
Ik vind het goed om aandacht te trekken voor de bijen, want zonder bijen kunnen wij mensen er eigenlijk ook niet zijn. En de bijen zijn heel erg belangrijk.
This way you don't force it on people. It will get a conversation started and people remember things better when they hear it in a good conversation. Better than when you trying to teach them, trying to force it upon them. You need to take care of the bees, they're dying. That doesn't really work.
Honey-driven and not money-driven. That's the connection, the bees, the students, and I am as a teacher, but I'm also a student. I learn from my students every day.
Yeah, go with the flow. Fly with the bees.